Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create a proper ping command that actually detects the latency for the bot as well as the latency for the specific Discord API. So in previous videos, I've actually created a very basic ping command that simply just replies with pong, and if you're not familiar with this command setup, then a link to my command base video will be in the video description. It's important that you follow along with that. So we're actually going to start from scratch. And so I'm going to simply say module.exports. It's going to be an empty object and our commands will be ping. And then we can say our callback, which will take in message, arguments, text, and client. These are going to be the four arguments that are passed in through our command base automatically. Now inside of here, I'm going to want to actually send a message. So I can say message.reply. We can say calculating ping dot dot dot. This is actually going to return a promise that we can handle with .then, and then this is going to give us the message object once it's actually sent. So I'm going to call this result message. So inside of here, I can create a constant called ping and set this equal to the result of result message.created timestamp minus message.created timestamp. And so these properties right here are going to be the Unix timestamp for whenever this was actually created. And if we find the difference, we see how long it took for the Discord bot to actually run that command after it was sent from our console. And so if we find the difference between the two, it's going to say how much time it took in milliseconds for the actual ping to calculate. And that's a good idea of how long it takes to actually communicate with our bot. So then we can say message.reply. We're going to have a template literal here. And we can say bot latency. And this is going to simply just insert in the ping. And then we can also say API latency. And this is going to be something that you can access through the actual client here. And so this is going to be how fast it is for the Discord bot to actually access the API. We could pass in client.ws for our WebSockets and then .ping, which is going to be a constant that essentially just has its ping. This will automatically be updated for us. And so we can just use that. If we save our file, we can run our bot with node index.js. You see registering command ping right here, and so everything is working. Going into Discord, I can then run exclamation point ping. And it says calculating ping, bot latency 134, API latency 160. However, here we see that it's sending another message. It might be cleaner for us if we just edit the existing message. So I can say result message.edit right here. And so we're going to edit the calculating ping message. And so now if I restart the bot, I can go back into Discord and I can run exclamation point ping. And it's going to say calculating ping, and then it's going to immediately edit it once it finds a result to 188 for the bot latency and 205 for the API latency. And so this is how you're going to calculate how long it takes for your Discord client to communicate with the actual Discord bot, as well as how long it takes for the Discord bot to actually communicate with the backend Discord API. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.